Underwriting for the production of Check Please has been provided by Bank of America, Bank of Opportunity.
Check Please Kansas City is brought to you by 360 Vodka, the world's first eco-friendly premium vodka. Saving the planet one glass at a time.
All right, well, it is a Check Please opportunity, and as you just saw on your screen there, we're talking about getting you out for a night on the town. Hi, I'm Randy Mason, and I've got some special guests with me in the studios of KCPT. Of course, if you're a fan of Check Please, you know what a great opportunity that show is for you to get out and about and sample some of the great restaurants, some of the great nightlife, some of the great food and drink opportunities that this city has to bring you. So that's what we're celebrating tonight. I really am glad that we can take this opportunity to celebrate a local production that I get to be peripherally involved with, as Check Please is now in its third year of being on public television here in Kansas City. And we know a lot of you really depend on the tips you get from it. So thanks for viewing. But here we've got a chance, as I say, to send you out for a great night on the town. We're going to take you to this lady's home turf. That's Independence. Cindy McLean, good to have you with us this evening here. You brought a man in a white coat as well.
I did. And this is Sean Leventhal, our executive chef at Cafe Verona.
Yeah, well, Cindy has a lot to do with the resurgence of things. She and her husband Ken down there in Independence Square and the environs around it. Cafe Verona being one of those places that's going to be on the night on the town.
Yes,
well,
it is.
What's in store when people pledge by calling in the number on the screen to take advantage of this membership opportunity for Check Please and KCPT to go out on the night on the town? And the number is right there on your screen. Please call and pledge your support right now. Cafe Verona, for example, might be offering up what?
It is dessert for that night.
Dessert and coffee.
Yep.
The roastery actually does our own coffee blend.
Yeah.
And we mess around with tiramisu, cannolis, but I think we're going to kind of step outside the box a little bit for night on the town.
Okay, so that's going to be obviously that end of the meal spectrum, but there's the Diamond Bowl, which is in the vicinity as well. What are they going to get us going with?
We're going to start there with an appetizer and our signature cocktail, which is a White Russian with a little bit of a twist.
Oh.
So, yeah, and the diamond, too much away.
Well, the Diamond Bowl is a bowling facility,
It is
right?
Bowling. We had been on the square for a while. We rehabbed it and redid it, and it's beautiful. It's a lot of fun to be in, but it's a good restaurant, too.
Cool. Well, has the White Russian got a little Big Lebowski touch to it?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay. Just figured that that wasn't coincidental, probably.
No. Bowling, Big Lebowski, kind of goes together.
Perfect. Well, I hope we're whetting people's appetite for this great opportunity out in Independence, where you may not have been too much recently. Some folks, you know, may not realize and think to themselves, oh, what, there's nothing out there, but they are...
They're wrong. Dead wrong.
Yeah. Things, give us a little capsule of how many different things are happening out there these days.
Well, we've been at it now. My husband Ken and I have been at it for 13 years, starting with Ophelia's restaurant. We now have 16 businesses, I think.
Very cool.
We just opened a Up Dog, a hot dog restaurant, so I think that kind of adds to my number of things. It's a mix of retails and restaurants, and there's a lot going on right now.
Yeah, it is. I was just down there the other day, and I was impressed with how much activity around that square that not that long ago did not look like that. And I think people owe it to themselves to go check it out. They're going to get these different opportunities. Like we say, Cafe Verona is going to have dessert and coffee on the night on the town night when the trolleys roll.
Right.
Our visitor, our viewers, people like you who watch these shows and like to see what's going on. How about Ophelia's? Because that's really where the meat and potatoes, if you will, might be.
Yes. That will be the entree part. We're going to go to Diamond Bowl first, then the Rhineland, and then, which is not our restaurant, but great German food. Ophelia's will be, like you said, meat and potatoes, and I think we're going to do a couple different entrees there. Seafood and a
meat dish.
Mm-hmm. I've never had a bad meal there, I'll just tell you that. Great stuff over there at Ophelia's, and actually we're going to take you right now into the Check Please episode where Cafe Verona got reviewed and where all the guest reviewers got to chime in about what they experienced out there. So that's what we're doing. We're putting on some excerpts from Check Please. We're getting your phone calls to get you on board as a member to go out on the night on the town. We'll tell you more. First, why don't you take a look at Doug Fost and the folks on Check Please.
Now, teacher of the deaf, Teresa Kraft, describes her pick in a way that everyone can understand. Exquisite Italian dining, Botticelli on the walls, an intimate atmosphere on the Independence Square. It's none other than Cafe Verona.
Cafe Verona came about in an effort to continue what we were already doing, which was to rejuvenate the square and bring people back to the square. And Cafe Verona was second in line of the restaurants that we designed. Everybody loves Italian, so it was just kind of a natural thing in the progression of cuisines.
Most of our menu is northern, focusing on Tuscan foods, but we do have some southern flares, meatballs, lasagna. We also play around with the Mediterranean, but mostly we try and keep it, you know, at the basics of Italian. We also have a really wonderful pastry chef who's developed some really amazing desserts for us. Service is impeccable. We have a wonderful wine list featuring a lot of Italian wines.
We were really going for the old world Italian feel, your neighborhood Italian restaurant. Of course, my favorite Renaissance artist was Botticelli, and so I got to have my favorite mural up there. And it's wonderful to sit out here on the courtyard at Cafe Verona and have a cappuccino late at night or to eat your dinner. It's just such a neat atmosphere. It's different, of course, than the plaza or the River Market or Westport, but I like it. I like the feeling. It's home. It's comfortable. I'm just happy that we're able to do that.
Teresa, how would you describe Cafe Verona to you, to us, your students?
Well, my first time there was we just happened to stop in on a weekend evening and had dinner, and it was so wonderful. We decided to go back, and the next time we went back, they remembered us.
And yeah, it's always nice.
We had a conversation about another couple's son who'd had a wedding supper there, and we were planning on getting married, and so that gave us an idea. And so we did that in March, and they did an absolutely beautiful meal for us, including a three-tiered wedding cake that was, my mom says, is the most delicious wedding cake she ever had. It's always one of those places where it doesn't matter what you pick, it's prepared wonderfully and it tastes good. I try something different every time I go.
So what are the favorites that?
Well, their signature dish is chicken orecchiette, I believe is how it's pronounced. And that was one of the dishes we had at our wedding. The other one we had for our wedding supper was a squash ravioli in brown butter, which is absolutely wonderful to have. They're friendly. The food is always wonderful. It's a beautiful restaurant.
And Rick, it's pretty hard to top a wedding meal, but how's your meal there?
It was excellent. I have to agree. I thought Cafe Verona was terrific. I had the carbonara, which is not necessarily something that you want if you're on a strict diet, but
it's very low-cal.
It was quite rich, but it wasn't a huge portion. It was just perfect. And one thing that they did that was really unique was they brought out what was a soft-boiled egg, because normally it's mixed with egg, and it had a crispy coating on the outside, and they cut it so that it just dropped in and you could mix it, and I thought that was really unique.
That's
and different.
A nice touch.
It was a nice touch, and it was almost like a signature. And we had the calamari for our appetizer, and our server was terrific.
Was the calamari like pre-cut, just cookie cutter pieces, or was it more like
It was mixed.
Tentacles,
you know,
mixed
tentacles
in. Oh, great.
Mixed in,
yeah.
And
awesome.
It came out in sort of a little paper bag, if you will, on a dish, and we just shared it. And really, for calamari, it was rich, but it still tasted light. It was great, and I liked that it was very comfortable. I thought the ambiance was really appealing. I liked the courtyard outside, and we really enjoyed it.
Jennifer, what did you have when you went to Verona?
Well, it's interesting, because I wanted to try the calamari, but I'm extremely picky, and they said it was frozen. So I went for the artichoke dip, which was actually excellent. It tasted like you were eating a supreme pizza somehow. It was
really
creamy.
And
creamy and cheesy. It was really great. And the courtyard was cool because I've been to Italy a couple times and it really reminded me of Italy. I was a little disappointed because I got there on a Tuesday and their website said that Tuesday was wine special night, and it turned out it was Wednesday and they had not updated their website. So the waitress was actually very nice about it not being wine special night, and she did mention the specials that they did have, some $6 glasses, and I had like a Pinot Grigio, I don't remember what kind, but my husband had a Norton. And he was really pleased about that.
Oh, that's cool to see a Missouri wine there. That's pretty cool. Assuming it was a Missouri Norton, most of the time it is. What'd you have to eat?
I had the chicken carciofi, which is artichokes in Italian, and it was really good. It was kind of like a breaded chicken that it went over. And they give you a wonderful side of like spaghetti bolognese with the carciofi, and I gorged myself on it because it was so good. So by the time I got my carciofi, I was pretty full, so I had them box it up. Plus, I wanted to try a dessert, so. And I did. I had this Italian pecan cream cake. Oh my goodness. They gave me the hugest piece ever. I think I spent
That's
3 days
Italian
eating it.
Cake.
Oh, it was wonderful.
That's the Italian,
so that's the Italian cream cake.
It was so good.
Terry, what do you think of bang for the buck there? What do you think of the pricing there?
Well, I have never felt like it was overpriced at all. It's a little more on the expensive side compared to some other places that we might go, but for what you get, I think it's well worth the price.
And Jennifer, bang for the buck? What do you think?
I did not think it was unreasonable at all. The portions were awesome.
Wonderful. How about you, Rick? What do you think of the pricing?
I thought it was an excellent bang for the buck. I thought it was very reasonable for the level of cuisine it was, and I thought it was quite good.
So how would you give a quick thumbnail description of the restaurant if somebody had never been there? How would you want them to think about it?
I'd say comfortable, quiet, engaging, service, rich, but with the right portions, it works real well.
And Jennifer, a quick thumbnail sketch, what do you think?
Oh, I think it was the closest to a true Italian dining experience I've had in the metro area, and reasonably priced, and overall just a nice place to go. And it doesn't have to be overpriced. It's not. You get great portions and good service.
Wonderful. Well, Terry, it's your restaurant. Sum it up for us.
I'd have to say it's probably one of my most favorite restaurants I've ever been to. It's someplace that my husband now knows we can go anytime and be happy. Delicious food. It's just a really, really nice place to go have a meal.
Wonderful. Well, you can decide for yourself at Cafe Verona, 206 West Lexington, Independence, Missouri, 816-833-0044. They're open for lunch and dinner every day except Sunday. Reservations are accepted, and the average tab per person without drinks is $15. The KCPT Night on the Town is so much fun that we're doing it again. And this time, it's a progressive dinner on Tuesday, October 25th, and we're walking historic Independence Square. We'll be featuring restaurants like Cafe Verona, Ophelia's, Diamond Bowl, and Rhineland. But the only way you can join us is if you make a donation to KCPT right now. Call or log on, and don't miss the fun.
I don't think I could say it any better than Doug Fost just did. Join the fun. It's October 25th, which is just a little over 2 months from now. You're going to have that great opportunity to sample some places you might not know about out in Independence, and you'll be supporting Check Please and the great programs we make here on KCPT, all about cool things in our own backyard. So take advantage right now of this opportunity. 888-203-1747. Get in on the Night on the Town. Cindy McClain, who has spent many a night in all those restaurants probably at one time or another. When you see that progression, what comes to mind? Starting out there at the Diamond Bowl and working your way. Anything in particular?
I just think it's an adventure. Like my day is every day, it'll be an adventure. Diamond Bowl is kind of a fun, kind of a loungy bowling alley, so I think that it's just a fun start. I think we'll have a good time there, and then as I understand it, we're going to walk over to the Rhineland, and Heinz is just a wonderful guy, and I know they'll take great care of us, and then we'll go into Ophelia's and see what they have in store for us.
Now, is that all this walking, or will there be a need to get on a conveyance at some point?
That I'm not sure about. I think that we are walking for a good bit of it.
So. Yeah, it makes sense. I mean, that's the beauty.
It's all in like one block area, so.
No conveyances needed. Let's all get a little exercise, and then we'll end up at Cafe Verona. That'll be the last stop. You said maybe thinking outside the box a little bit?
Right. I spin on Italian favorite.
Yeah, well, and some good roastery coffee to wash it all down. You guys have probably never done anything quite like this, maybe? I don't know. Maybe the Independence Square has seen this kind of activity before.
Not really, I mean, we've done our own kind of progressive dinner, or we have customers who kind of, because they love us, they'll set up their own progressive dinner, and they just have a lot of fun. Because it is in one block, the ambiance is great, you can't beat it, and, you know, you can park and walk and just enjoy this, the courthouse and Truman's history. And
I was going to say, Harry would endorse the notion, and I think our viewers appreciate, you know, the word of Mr. Truman on this. Go for it right now by calling 888-203-1747. We're here in the studios of KCPT, which is where Check Please is taped, and watching Doug Fost and the guys just a moment ago talk about Cafe Verona. That was pretty cool. They said, you know, said really nice things about the restaurant. It was a great opportunity for people to learn about a place they might not have heard. And I guess you probably heard a few folks who'd watched.
A few, yeah. It was a wonderful review. I, you know, completely agree. The spinach artichoke that Sean, sausage artichoke dip that Sean does is addicting, pretty much. And once you've had it, you have to come back.
Yeah, calamari was out there. Oh. Of course, you guys do wine, all sorts of good things that happen at Cafe Verona with the Italian spin. When you're on the dinner, you can also check out Rhineland, the Diamond Bowl, Cafe Verona. It's going to be four great places to go on Independence Square, October 25th. $100 pledge gets you that chance to go be with other KCPT viewers, folks who watch Check Please. You can compare notes. You can give them your tips. You can do your own Check Please on the occasion. It'll be fun out there. October 25th, $100 per pledge. Speaking of Check Please, we've got to get back to more of the excerpts from it. We're trying to incentivize you to make that call, pledge your support to KCPT. And to do so, I think we're going to go see what they had to say about Ophelia's a while back on Check Please Kansas City. Take a look and make that call.
Dentist Melinda Meredith says the food at her pick is mouth-watering, kind of like the tooth cleaning paste, only this time you're encouraged to swallow.
Ophelia's was opened in May of 1998 as a multi-function restaurant and inn. It has a full-service restaurant, a banquet room that will seat up to 300 people, and it used to be white tablecloth when we opened, and we've kind of made it more casual fine dining. Currently, it's still a destination, but we want to make it comfortable for people that don't want to dress up on their night off.
We've got a lot of different things on the menu. What I've tried to do is make it a little more American regional with a lot of French influences. We do have some southern fared items. We've got buttermilk fried oysters. We do some fun things like homemade Kansas City strip beef jerky. Everything is made from scratch. We do a lot of local products. I put a lot of hard work into the menu and a lot of development with it to make it a little more seasonal, a little more local than it had been in the past.
Ophelia's continues to evolve, to remain fresh and new, so that people will recognize Ophelia's but be surprised by the innovations that are now present.
Yeah, Melinda, how's your sweet tooth at Ophelia's?
The sweet tooth is definitely satisfied at Ophelia's. We've gone there for our anniversaries a few years, and my husband was pleasantly surprised to find such a, I guess, gem in Independence, mm-hmm. in the suburbs.
So what do you like to eat there? What do you think people should eat there?
I love their steak, any kind of red meat from there, and wine.
Good
it's
steak.
My favorite. Did
Good
you? I'm glad
steak.
You liked it.
Yes.
We went for brunch this time because I'd never been for brunch, so I convinced my husband we have to go to try to refresh our memories.
This is only R&D, just research and development.
Yes,
that's
yes. And it was a brunch buffet, so it's never quite the same quality when it's a buffet. But the prime rib, it was worth it just for that. It was amazing for brunch.
They
prime
have
rib.
Prime rib on a brunch buffet.
Oh yeah.
Sweet.
Amazing.
Yeah, that's almost crazy. It is almost crazy.
Sweet.
What'd you have for wine?
I didn't have any wine at brunch, but before I've had, I forgot what it was exactly, a red wine flight, which is fun for me because I don't know much about wine. So then I get to try several different ones, and I like this one with the undertones. So I feel
undertones of prime rib and horseradish.
Yes. Yeah, by the end of it, yeah. I had a cranberry mimosa actually with breakfast or with brunch. It was pretty tasty.
Any appetizers that you've had there that you'd recommend?
Yes. I love, they've got chips that are homemade there with blue cheese.
Uh-huh.
Did you have it?
Uh-huh.
Had those.
Oh, yeah.
Tasty.
Uh-huh.
This man speaks from experience.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So,
good stuff.
And there's also a dip. It's a chorizo and cheese dip that's fantastic. So I could just eat appetizers.
That sounds like something that should be on your list, Ryan. What do you think?
We had, I don't know if it's the same thing, because there's two different types of chips. The one that you had has the chorizo. The one that we had were russet potatoes and sweet potato chips.
Cool.
I've done both.
You've done both.
Clarify.
Okay. Okay.
Yes.
To be complete.
And yes.
To get your R&D done.
Any chips.
Oh my God, it was good. We had to keep ourselves from eating it so we knew we'd have enough room. And then they pour sea salt over everything. Oh, it was just delicious.
So. Yeah, good. So was that your first and only visit?
Yes. Thank you. That's all I can say is thank you. We'll be back. It was a great time. The fact that there was a guy sitting there doing a rhythm section with a piano right in front was awesome. We went on, I think, a Saturday night. The food was awesome. The service was excellent. The waiter actually, I got the scallops and I asked him for a recommendation because I usually drink red wine. I said, I know you should usually drink a white with seafood. So he actually made two recommendations, brought out small glasses for me to try. And
now
see
we're
what
talking. I mean, I think that's great service.
Yeah,
that's exactly
he did an exceptional job. He did an exceptional job. And then on top of that, he was extremely helpful, not overbearing at all. Wonderful service.
Great, wonderful. Well, Melissa, how was your experience?
It was really good. Again, out of my comfort zone, independent. And I feel like I've heard...
iPhones out, girlfriend's sitting next to you going,
much,
I don't know, call for backup.
Story. No, it was really nice. The atmosphere was really nice. We went on a Friday night, but it was pretty much empty. And there was a piano player there, which was really nice the whole night. And we got a bottle of Riesling, which was lovely.
That'll work.
And I asked her if we should get like the escargot or the mussels appetizer, and she said that both of them were really good. So we ended up going with the escargot, and it was.
Yeah, snails are snails, you know.
Well, it was all right. I probably wouldn't order it again. And then the entree, I got the sea bass with the tabbouleh and the spinach and the something kind of vinaigrette. It was really good. I mean, it was like it had like a little crispy thing on top because it was pan-seared, mm-hmm. and it was just. It was really good, and it was a really good size portion of it, too. So even though I didn't have any more room left, I forced myself to get a dessert. and I don't remember, like, what they called it, but it was basically, like, layers of chocolate cake goodness.
I saw it.
With, like,
I'm going, I kind of want some of that.
Chocolate mousse, and then, like, back. White chocolate mousse, and mm-hmm. then, like, sprinkled with cocoa powder. It was really good.
You know, Melinda, for you, Independent Square, I mean, is that, you know, to me, it's a historical place. And I think part of Ophelia's story really is that they helped bring Independence Square back.
I love it. Yeah, I'm from Independence, so it's kind of got a special place in my heart. But it's great to see it being revitalized. And you probably went when it was too late to go to the stores, but there are some amazing non-chain stores.
Yeah. Well, so what do you think about the bang for buck there, about the value there, Melinda?
I think it's great. They have an expensive lunch as well. It's not the same experience. But I think it's a good deal. It's not cheap, but it's a fabulous anniversary place.
Yeah, if you want quality food, you're going to pay some money for it. And for the serving size that we got, my wife got the steak.
Sounds like she didn't get all the steak. I'm going to guess.
She got full. I got some. It was great.
There you go.
But yeah, I mean, you spend $32 for this huge piece of meat.
Enough to share.
You know, and then I had people. The scallops were reasonably priced. I mean, and you're getting high quality food.
Did Melissa, you get dessert? Oh, sorry.
Yeah, no, please. You
what
did dessert?
You
creme brulee, baby. Oh my God, it was good. I've never had creme brulee that was just not disgusting. I wanted more. We could have ordered a second one. It was so good. You know, it was really nice. Had a nice little lemon flavor to it. It's a vanilla creme brulee. But, you know, they turn around and cook down the sugar on the top to make it hard.
Oh, yeah. It's got to be
and you're
the
like,
last thing going.
Oh. It was excellent.
Well, Melissa, what did you think of the value there?
Oh, it was good. It was, I mean, for, it was really good food, and I thought it was, it was great.
So. Well, Melinda, it was your recommendation. Sum it up for us.
I think it's just this just delicious little, not really well-known place on a really cool part of town with a lot of history, with fabulous service.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Well, try it yourself at Ophelia's Restaurant and Inn, 201 North Main in Independence, Missouri. Their number is 816-461-4525. They're open Monday through Thursday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m., Friday and Saturday until 10 p.m., and from 11 a.m. to 2:30 for Sunday brunch. Reservations are accepted, and the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $25.
A really cool place with great service, good food. Hey, that must be music to Cindy McClain's
yes,
ears.
Yes, it is. Like, it is.
Yeah,
I think we do a good job.
Yeah, and Sean Leventhal, executive chef here with the folks who are helping us put on the night on the town that's taking people out to Independence Square, where, I don't know, not too coincidentally, you'll find Ophelia's Cafe Verona, Rhineland Restaurant, and the Diamond Bowl. Those are the four places we're going to take you to as a member of KCPT, kind of celebrating Check Please here and this opportunity to remind those of you who watch shows like this, who learn about great restaurants, who get to talk about this place that they've discovered thanks to KCPT. Hey, go discover a new one yourself on October 25th. It's a Tuesday night.
Yep.
You're going to be able to go out on a, I predict it will be a lovely, beautiful.
It's going to be perfect.
You know, isn't that late October?
It's
It's perfect.
Always good.
Always.
And $100 per ticket benefits KCPT and lets you have a great time at these four places. Cindy, why would people choose to do this besides the weather?
Well, not only because it's a great square, the restaurants are great, the food is great, the atmosphere, it's beyond great. It's because Ken McLean and my husband and I love KCPT, and we want to do everything we can to support it. It's actually our favorite channel.
You don't need to grimace when you say that. It's actually a really good
thing. I think it's a great thing.
No, we think the McLeans have been wonderful to Independence Square, to the city, and so many good things have happened there. Just like the lady on Check Please was saying, you know, there's non-chain shops. There's a whole sense of community developing. You guys done a great job.
It is. It's a nice neighborhood pocket almost, and it just has a great feeling. A nice cocoon for people to come and enjoy great food and just be and just relax, you know.
Well, your chef over there has to kind of really get his act together to get some of those things going for that night. A little pressure there, or you got other things on your mind right now anyway?
No, we do this all the time, so it'll be a nice night for everybody to come out.
You thinking things? What can I come up with that will dazzle one place to follow up with another?
Well, challenge your sensibilities, absolutely.
Any secrets you're going to reveal about what people might have in store at any of these opportunities?
Fall-influenced menus.
He's not giving it up.
No, he really isn't.
We
may have to take him and shake him later, but it doesn't sound like we're going to get any real details. It's just going to be a cool night.
Yeah.
And October 25th is lovely time. I really think often you get your very best nights right about then. $100 ticket. Benefits KCPT, like we heard from Cindy. It is a lot of people's favorite TV station. This is your chance to act on what you enjoy, what you benefit from. Making the call makes you feel really good. And then on October 25th, you're going to get out and really, you know, see some places that I'm guessing you might not have seen. The Diamond Bowl. Tell me again, what's that place like?
Diamond Bowl is bowling. It's kind of boutique bowling. I'm not sure. It's cool. And it's 8 lanes and a restaurant. It's a grill. We have sliders and we have fish sliders. We have really good nachos.
It's one of the newer additions, and you now have a hot dog place. You guys you're catching it all. It's part of what is really fun. I think when we do Check Please, we get to learn about new places, and I think when people get out something like this, they're really going to have that experience that they can carry back to their friends and tell them about it.
Yeah, it's just something different to do, and it's just a great place to be, and it's easy to get to. You do not fall off the face of the earth when you cross state line, or even from Kansas City, it's like 10 minutes, 15 minutes. It's right there.
Yeah, we're talking about Independence Square. We're talking about October 25th. Cindy McLean, Sean Leventhal here from the restaurants that you're going to be visiting. I'm convinced of it. You won't fall off the edge of the earth.
That's right.
We've got that proven right here. October 25th, $100 pledge. We've got volunteers ready to take your call. They're here in the studio, the other end of 1-888-203-1747. And if not for this, just think about how much Check Please in general has benefited you and how many great restaurant tips you've heard and seen watching this show, and what a cool host Doug Fost is, and he'll be part of that adventure as well, and just getting to hang with Doug is a treat in itself. So make the call, give it as a gift. We got to get out of here now. Thank you, Cindy. Thank you, Sean. It's been good having you here, and you have a night on the town. Make that call.